Hello and welcome to this video. We're going to talk about the MITRE intrusion policy changes in release 7.3 of the Cisco Secure Firewall. So here I am on my FMC, the Firewall Management Center. I'm going to go over to intrusion policy. Let's take a look at some of the changes in 7.3 here. I'm going to take a look at this balance policy. I've got balance security, security of connectivity. Look at the Snort 3 version. That's where all the changes are. First of all, you notice we have this interesting wizard that comes up. It's really kind of a documentation feature. It's not really a wizard, but it leads you through and just explains policy layers and what they look like. It's kind of cool. The intrusion policy, it shows what a policy is, how it works, how it starts off with layers. Those are flattened into an intrusion policy. So it explains things like the base layer, what group overrides are, recommendations, and rule overrides. So we're checking out just to give a quick overview if you're not familiar with, you need to brush up on the policy layers and things. They have this nice summary overview page now. Kind of cool, shows up here constantly in this view, the active rules you have, number set to block, number set to alert, the rule overrides, group overrides, you've got recommendations down here, whether they're in use or not, which they are in this policy. You can view your effective policy. Viewing the effective policy really gives you that per rule list that the kind of you're used to seeing. So you can enable or disable rules individually. Now, using groups is actually a much better way to do that, but this gives you that same view you've been used to, where you can go and change the state of the rules. So let's go over and take a look at some of these new MITRE features then. So those are going to be found over here on the group overrides. So group overrides in 7.3 is going to start default to showing you overridden groups. You probably don't have any, so switch to all groups. It'll show you all the groups. So we have three kind of major categories. So we've had local before. I have local rules here and expand that. I've got some custom rule groups I created. And then rule categories, used to those too. So we've got the browser category file. The one I always use as an example is the browser category. We've got Chrome and Firefox and all these. But we have a new one now called MITRE. So MITRE shows the ATT&CK framework. So ATT&CK is adversary, techniques, tactics, and common knowledge. And underneath there, you have the enterprise framework. And of course, with each one of these is the groups. So we have things like resource development, execution, command and control, if you expand those. And if you're familiar with MITRE at all, you recognize the techniques here. So now what these are is just another way to group rules, right? So now this policy has a base security level, which in this case is level 2 because it's a balance based on the balanced policy. So these rule groups pretty much just inherit that security setting. So they have no security settings of their own. So you notice here, if you look at this one, the security level for this group is really not set because we're not setting a security level specifically on this group of rules. Basically, the whole policy is set to level 2. So if you wanted to change the security level for this particular rule group, this is how you do it. Now, one thing to note with these, if I click on the standard application layer protocol, for instance, you notice there's 4,600 rules in this group. This is a pretty big one. So this is a pretty large group of rules. So anything you do with the security level here is gonna affect a lot of rules. So if you want to bump it up to, say, level 3 just for this rule group, you're going to have a fair amount of additional rules probably enabled. Some of them are smaller. The impact group here, let's see, endpoint denial of service, application or system exploitation is the technique there. 1,500 rules. Exfiltration over C2 channel, 49 rules. So as you can see, what this basically does is give you a way to set security levels on a MITRE group basis. Now again, a lot of these rules are already enabled. For instance, let's take a look at these. So 49 rules, let's look at those in the rule overrides. So you can see the base policy already sets a number of these enabled. There's only eight of the 49 are set to block out of the gate. So if you did want to improve this protection for this particular area, you could bump the security level up. Now again, what I want to make clear is this already has security level 2. Even though there's not a security level showing here, it is still 2. So if I set it to 2, it's not actually going to change anything. Look at the rules we have now. We had 8 rules to start with. We still have 8 rules. So again, it's going to be used to override that security level if it's different. But if it's the same, setting it to 2 doesn't do anything. So Don't waste your time setting the security level to the same level you've already selected at the base. So if we edit again and we change it to security level 3, let's see what that does. It's a more aggressive approach. So you notice now what happens is we have more rules enabled. So another 10 rules enabled looks like by enabling security level 3 in this case. That's how you would use these groups if you really wanted to tweak your rules based on the MITRE technique, then you can do it that way. By the way, you can revert back if you change your mind to revert back to default. It's pretty easy to just revert back to default here. So let me talk about one other feature having to do with MITRE in 7.3, and that is in the intrusion analysis. So if we go to analysis, intrusion events, we have a couple fields we've added to the intrusion events as well related to MITRE. One in particular, one's related to the other rule groups. Let's take a look. Looking at the our default workflow here, mine happens to be impact and source. That's not the one out of the box, it's just the one I've selected for my default. Have one event here. Now to see these fields, I'm going to go over to the table view. So let's click table view here. And in the table view, these columns were actually added out of the box. They've actually added these to the default table view. Now the table view, if you're not aware, doesn't contain every single field in the event. An easy way to see all the fields is to click one of these, like say destination country, and you can see all the fields available. So these ones are selected, but there's actually more columns I could add here if I wanted to. The columns I'm looking for here are actually already there. So they're way over here on the right. I have the MITRE and the rule group. Those are the two added columns. So MITRE will tell you if this rule has an applicable MITRE technique, and they do not all have that. Not every rule has a MITRE technique associated with it, but this one in particular does. So this event that triggered, but click on the technique, it will show here the MITRE technique. So there's the attack framework, enterprise initial access. This is the exploit a public facing application technique. The rule group shows you the Talos rule group this rule is in. So this is not MITRE, this is the Talos rule group. So that's under rule category, server web applications. So the MITRE column tells you the MITRE rule group you'll find it in, and the rule group tells you the Talos rule group you'll find this rule in. One place you might want to use these categories is in your intrusion event reports, where you can sort, search, or group those events based on that MITRE technique and tactic, and understand more about the events that are occurring in your organization that way. So that wraps it up for the new MITRE ATT&CK features in release 7.3 of the Cisco Secure Firewall. And as always, happy snorting!